In this project, I'm going to talk about the development environment for developing applications for this device. Generally, we have two options. One is to use Expressive's ESP-IDF. This is the official way for ESP32 development to be able to use the Redis features. You can also access all parts of the ESP32 and complete your project in the most efficient way. However, as a downside, you need to prepare a separate development environment for ESP-IDF. This can be a huge hurdle for beginners and seems a lot more difficult than the Arduino platform. So some people prefer to develop ESP32 in Arduino IDE. It presents us with a very familiar development environment and we can start developing very easily. The downside of this is that you have to wait for new Expressive hardware or ESP-IDF's new features to be available on Arduino environment. I'm sure they will do an update, but you will have to wait to get the Redis features. In addition, in terms of system structure, there is unnecessary code and memory consumption because one more layer called Arduino platform is created over the ESP-IDF. Nevertheless, the Arduino IDE makes it very easy to build and do everything simply. So in my case, I'm using both of them. Projects that can be done on Arduino platform are developed through Arduino IDE, and when new hardware and special functions of ESP-IDF are required, projects are developed based on ESP-IDF with VS Code. And there is no right answer, so you can develop it the way you want to do it. The one I have now has a very similar form factor to Google Nest as I mentioned in the previous video. It has no touchscreen, just one button and magnetic rotary switch. So UI UX development should be based on this. In order to create an UI UX similar to Google Nest, using a tool such as Scaleline Studio would enable faster development. Anyway, today I don't touch UI but the development environment for this device. This manufacturer is sharing a base project based on ESP-IDF for development. If you plan to start your project based on ESP-IDF, please stick with it. It's not a bad choice and you can try many things like using the native USB interface. Anyway, I created a base project for Arduino so you can start developing in the Arduino environment. This is a base project that contains the graphic drivers, button trigger, and magnetic rotary switch you need for your project. All files in this folder should be downloaded. I recommend that you download only a specific folder, not the entire repository. All of these URLs are in this video description. Please check this out. Here is a downloaded folder. As you know, Arduino IDE requires the folder name and INO file name to be the same, so need to change the folder name to be the same as the file name. Open this in the Arduino IDE. I assume you have the ESP32 Arduino core installed. If not installed, you can install the ESP32 board after adding the URL for the ESP32 board information in preferences. Now we need to install the required libraries. The graphics driver used is GFX for Arduino. Install this. All the UI on the screen is drawn using LVGL, so install LVGL as well. The current version is 8.3.5. If your LVGL development is already ready, this part is unnecessary. I'm showing it again for those just starting out. If you look in the Arduino library folder, there is an LVGL folder. Copy the lvconfig template.h file here into the source folder, then rename its file to lvconfig.h. Let's open this new file through any text editors. For now, you need to change only two things here. Line number 15. We will use LVGL, so enable this. And line number 88. Since we will use it in Arduino environment, we need to use Arduino custom tick. This is all the LVGL environment settings. You can now do LVGL build on Arduino. Alright, this completes the preparation for our first build. If you run into any problems here or have any questions, please leave a message in the video comments. To build, let's choose your device. First, set ESP32S3 dev module. Most importantly, PSRAM must be enabled. This is necessary because PSRAM is used to create the display buffer. This yellow burning tool is required to upload your program to this device. This is a TTL to serial burning tool. And that's it. This is all to get your project off the ground. And now let's build it and flash it to your device. There are two buttons on the screen. Since it is not a touch screen, you can use the rotation switch to change which object is being selected. A click event is triggered by pressing a hardware button on the focused object. It increments the button number by 1 every time an event occurs. This is a very simple example, but it means that the device in part required for UI/UX development is prepared. We can use the magnetic rotation switch to select the next object and press the screen, the hardware button to trigger some event on the selected object. It's not easy for us to create a Google Nest-like interface from scratch all at once. However, if we implement them one by one, I think a similar screen composition will be possible. Today's video ends here. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.